Sunshine Fund offering along with their tithes today. And use the red envelope with Sunshine Fund. If you don't have one in your pew, just let us know. We got plenty. So, our puppet ministry is today, and it's entitled God's Love. Used it somewhere or stored it somewhere. We don't know where it's at. But anybody knows, we'll just let Sue know. Hey, right there it is. It's Rodney got it. I see it now. I didn't even look for it. That's why we make announcements, so we can find stuff. All right, any other announcements? Got a card I'd like to read. Those who bring sunshine to the lives of others cannot keep it from themselves. Sir James Barry. Dear church family, thank you so much for the Sunshine Fund, but more than that, thank you for all your prayers. I believe in the power of prayer, and I am trusting in God to see me through it. Please continue to pray for me during this difficult time. Love in Christ. Robbie Benton. Definitely keep in our prayers. This time, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Any, by it with him. We all have unspoken prayers. Any outspoken.
Just remember, Mr. Yates, Chester, Price, I'm not sure if they're in election. I think we're involved. But people follow the best of it.
Brad to be remembered. He's been sick this week. Remember him and Sarah?
My throat is back to normal down east. There's still a lot of people that are without homes and still a lot of work to be done. So don't want to forget them just because our lives are back to normal. They're just going to be close to us. Just don't forget them. Remember our country. Remember our young people. We're going to have a mighty struggle ahead of them.
Said earlier that we're honored to have a memorial service over at the hospice center today. Those that have lost lives this year. And they're remembering day today, 3 o'clock. And just remember all those. I don't know how they do that job. You know, special people do that. EMTs, firemen, policemen. Remember all those.
Remember the soldiers that were killed in Jordan, and the soldiers that were killed in Afghanistan. Remember their families that, you know, they put their faith in Christ.
Anybody out? Anyone else?
Lord, we come to you this morning and thank you for the opportunity to wake up and worship you, Father. We pray that all those who are sick can turn to you and trust in you, Lord. And those who don't know you, Father, we pray that in your will and your timing that you can bring them to you and to heal yourself, Lord. We thank you for today and all the blessings you've shed upon us, Lord. We pray that those in heartache can seek you and find comfort, Lord. And we can be comforting for each other, Father. And we pray
joy unspeakable. We should have words up here. We ain't got that joy today, but before the day ends. Let's sing out this morning.
Thank you. Some bright morning, when this life is over, I'll fly away to that home on God's celestial shore.
Special this morning, Brother Danny. No, I'm sorry. Janet's going to sing this one today.
That's a hard act to follow. I love that it's here in the twin scene. And Scott, it's so good to see you today. I'm so glad you're back with us. I got so excited when I saw you in the sound room, I forgot to tell Austin about the song we were singing and that I was doing a solo. So my mistake, also, I'm sorry, but we're glad to have you back. The song I'm going to sing is The Anchor Holds. I understand this is our preacher's favorite song, and I yes. hope I can do it justice. But I'm so glad that God is my anchor today.
Yes.
Out on the ocean. thy faithful sight unknown. And yet his eyes were watching me. Anchor holds, though the ship is battered, the anchor holds, though the sails are torn, I have fallen eyes.
Are you glad this morning that your anchor holds?
Amen.
In spite of the storm. We welcome you to the house of God today. We trust that none of us have come for any other purpose but to worship and to praise and to magnify the name of our God. His name is Jesus Christ. Before I get started on his sermon today, let me say that I truly appreciate everything that was done to honor me last Sunday at the luncheon and all the wonderful gifts and things that were given to me. It means a lot to realize that you have people that are standing with you to support the ministry of Jesus Christ here at this church. And again, we say thank you. Acts 5, if you want to read along with us this morning. It always has amazed me that the God we worship and serve would allow his church and his people to suffer persecution when they try to do good things in the world in which they live. That is nothing new to our time. It has existed since the early church was formed. And I want to talk this morning for the next few minutes about the reasons that the church and Christian people suffer persecution. If you have your Bibles, turn to the 5th chapter of Acts. Let's begin reading in the 12th verse, where God's word says, "And by the hands of the apostles were many signs and wonders wrought among the people, and they were all with one accord in Solomon's porch. And of the rest durst no man join himself to them, but the people magnified them. And believers were the more added to the Lord, multitudes both of men and women." Insomuch that they brought forth the sick into the streets and laid them on beds and couches, that at the least the shadow of Peter passing by might overshadow some of them. Right. There came also a multitude out of the cities round about unto Jerusalem, bringing sick folks and them which were vexed with unclean spirits, and they were healed every one. And they were healed every one.
Amen.
Then the high priest rose up, and all that were with him, which is the sect of the Sadducees, and were filled with indignation or envy, and laid their hands on the apostles and put them in the common prison. May we ask God's blessings upon the reading of his precious and holy and inerrant and unchanging word. want you to realize that there are many causes of persecution upon Christian men and women today and the church today, which we find here in this fifth chapter of Acts. I want you to realize that one of the reasons why persecution comes upon Christian men and women today is because of signs and wonders and miracles. Now, I don't know about you, but I'm a man that believes that miracles still occur every day in our lives.
Amen.
You see, our problem is that so many times we're caught up with life itself and the business of life that we don't stop and realize what a blessing that God has poured out upon us each day. Amen. You see, I believe that if we were able to get up this morning, put our clothes on, and come to this place of worship, I believe that you and I have been truly blessed today. You say, well, Danny, why does God still work signs, wonders, and miracles? I believe that there are at least three reasons why He does. The first reason is to see, to show that God is still exists. You see, if there was not for the wonders of God, we would begin to doubt if God really exists. You say, Danny, the people of God must oftentimes doubt that He even exists. And I tell you that they do. And we have it not only in our day, but even back in the time of Moses. The people of Israel had been captive of Egypt so long, for over 400 years of bondage, that they began to think that their God didn't exist, or if He did exist, that He had forgotten them. No, no, and no. God never forgets His people. God will never forget His people, and He will never forsake His people. He may put them on a shelf for a while, like He did the nation of Israel, but He hasn't forgotten. To prove that God exists. The second reason is to prove that His Son, Jesus Christ, is alive and still actively at work upon the earth, saving and meeting the needs of men and women. Do you believe that Jesus Christ is alive today, first of all? And secondly, do you believe that He's interested in the lives of men and women today? You see, if we don't believe that Jesus Christ is still interested in the lives of men and women, then we should not be worshiping Him this morning. But I declare unto you that He is a God that still can work miracles, and that He is a concern, and He is still interested in the lives of each one of us that are here today. The third reason why I believe that signs and wonders and miracles are still existing today is that it is the people who trust God that God looks after and that possesses His authority and power upon the earth. I want you to understand something this morning. And that Bible, if you're holding one in your hand and laying on your lap this morning, and this one that's laying on this sacred stand up here this morning, there are many promises of God in that book. But they are only to people who believe in Him, who worship Him, and who trust Him. I want you to realize today that the promises of God will not be found in the hell holes of the world. I want you to realize today that the promises of God are not for the people that are out there in this world doing all sorts of things. It can be for those people, but they have to come to God and they have to admit that He exists and that He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him. And I ask us this morning, do we believe that He will reward us for being in His house today? Do we truly believe that God will reward us for diligently seeking Him? Do we believe that God will reward us for dedicating our life and our efforts and our whole faith on Him to provide for us. When we can't provide for ourselves, do you believe that God will provide for you? You see, the world does not understand the signs and wonders, and what it does not, what the world does not understand, it often rejects, mocks, abuses, and persecutes. You see, the reason that people don't want to believe in miracles today is because they can't explain them by modern science. Well, let me tell you something today. If you only believe what you can see, if you only believe what science can explain to you, you are missing the great blessings of God. Because you've got to realize that even the breath that you're breathing in and out of your lungs today would not be possible if it were not for the blessings of God. The heart that is beating in the chest of every one of us here today, the next heartbeat belongs to God. And it is only through the grace and mercy of God that you have the next heartbeat. So why? Why do people doubt that God is still in the miracle working business? I believe that one of the reasons is that miracles show the ignorance and inability of man. You see, a lot of times what people can't explain, they say, oh, that just happened. Let me tell you something today, friends. Nothing just happens by accident. There is a reason and there is a purpose for everything under the sun, as Solomon said. And I want you to realize that nothing goes under God's radar. I want you to realize that He is sitting on His throne this morning where He has always been. He has not given it up. He has not given up one thing of His power, one ounce of His power, if you want to measure it like that, and He never will. God is still God, and He always will be, and He always has been, whether we want to accept it or not. Secondly, miracles show that there's a being higher than man. A God to whom man must surrender and obey. Oh, you see, here's where the problem comes in with the world. We live in a world that doesn't want to admit that there's anything bigger than themselves. They don't. A lot of people don't want to think that they've got to surrender to anybody. That you don't. That you might not have to surrender to any person in this world. But let me tell you something. If you want the blessings of God, you must surrender to Him, and you must obey Him, and you must do what He says. The Ten Commandments weren't a list of suggestions. The gospel of Jesus Christ isn't a list of suggestions. When God says, come ye out from among them and be ye a separate and a peculiar people, that's exactly what He means. When He says, thou shalt not covet, He means that, and He doesn't want you to want what somebody else has got.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, help me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near.